Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats. The Stellar Award ceremony will begin shortly. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome to the stage the 2023 Stellar Honorees, led by the East River High School Falcon Drumline and the 2022 Stellar Winners. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage tonight's Mistress of Ceremonies, Nancy Alvarez, and Master of Ceremonies, Jamie Holmes.
Good evening, buenas noches, OCPS, and welcome to the 2023 Stellar Awards. Wonderful to be here with you tonight. I'm Nancy Alvarez.
And I'm Jamie Holmes. It's so great to see you all and be here. You may know us as the hosts of The Slice, news from OCPS. Maybe you saw us somewhere else. I don't know.
So we've been on TV a really long time. Jamie, how many years?
Like 30-something.
30-something? Yeah, I'm still on TV. I'm at Channel 2 now, by the way. So take note. Everybody change the channel.
Noon and 4 o'clock, by the way. Yeah. Any Nielsen families in the house?
Yet everywhere we go now, it's not, hey, are you the people from the news? It's, hey, you're from Mondays with Maria. That's what we get. Am I right? Amazing. What better way to kick off our program than a well-deserved grand entrance for all of tonight's honorees? Wasn't that awesome? Thank you to the East River High School Falcon Drumline and our grand marshals. Yes, the 2021-22 Stellar Award winners. Assistant Principal of the Year, Kenya Nelson Warren, who has actually been promoted to principal at Evans High. Where are you, Evans? Where are you? Okay. Principal of the Year, Julie Helton, formerly of Castleview Elementary, now Executive Area Director of the Southwest Learning Community. So another promotion there. And the Teacher of the Year, Nancy Welch from the Orange Technical College main campus. Also, congratulations to Support Person of the Year, Joy Hamilton of Sunridge Middle School, who is not able to be here with us tonight, but a big congratulations as well. And thank you for being guiding stars for staff and students alike. Let's give all of our honorees a huge round of applause and make some noise in this ballroom tonight.
First of all, I'd like to say that's a really big room back there for all those people that came out. So congratulations, everyone. Tonight, we are celebrating more than 450 employees selected to represent their schools or work locations as an assistant principal of the year, a principal of the year, a support person of the year, or a teacher of the year. So this celebration honors the best of the best, right, among Orange County Public Schools' dedicated employees. Every one of you has proven you are committed to excellence and to leading students to success. So as you strike your pose tonight and do a Vogue and take selfies throughout tonight's event, most of you know what Vogue is, right? Okay, good. We encourage you to share those photos on social media. Use the hashtag OCPSStellar. So if you forget the hashtag, you're going to find it in tonight's event program right in the back cover. Now, we're thrilled, of course, this year to also welcome some of the friends, the family, and colleagues of our honorees online. If you know someone else who'd like to tune in, we are live tonight, live broadcast. So, you know, watch yourself. So if you know anybody that's watching, tell them to tune in to OCPS.net. And if you haven't begun already, please enjoy the salads at your table. Those are the green things.
So inside the program, you can find out more about the finalists and see the list of all of tonight's honorees. Have you all found your name in the program? Raise your hand if you found your name in the program already. So look for it. You're in there. I also want to let you know there will be door prize drawings later tonight. You must be present to win, so be sure to stick around because there's a chance it could be your lucky night with some awesome door prizes that we have. Also, there is a QR code you need to know about. There it is right there. To register your car for parking. That will make sure you are able to park for free. And the code is also posted at the help desk in the lobby. At this time, I would like to call for the presentation of colors by the Edgewater High School Marine Corps Junior ROTC under the direction of Lieutenant Colonel Brian Lucas. Please stand and remain standing until the colors are retired. Thank you. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you to the Edgewater High School Marine Corps Junior ROTC. You can be seated. Thank you.
And tonight's celebration would not be possible without the generous support of our sponsors. Addition Financial, our Galaxy sponsor. Our Lunar sponsor, Cigna. Comet sponsor, Ernie Morris. Our Meteor sponsors, Intrado, OUC, Rogue Mobile, Rollins College, Shingle Schultz Architecture, and Silvis Painting. Of course, our host sponsor, Rosen Shingle Creek, and our photography sponsor, Strawbridge Studios. So let's give them all a round of applause and thank them for their support. So we will be back a little bit later, but before we take our seats, let's hear a message here from Addition Financial.
On behalf of Addition Financial, I would like to congratulate all of the honorees being recognized at tonight's Stellar Awards ceremony. As a credit union founded by Orange County teachers, Addition Financial has a strong heritage here in Central Florida, and we believe in education as a vehicle for transforming lives. Our roots in education have shaped who we are as a credit union for more than 85 years, as we believe that empowering our community begins in the classroom. We at Addition Financial are proud of our long-standing partnership with OCPS. Through our school district debit card program, we've donated more than $700,000 to the foundation since the program's inception in 2009. Every time the card is swiped, we make a donation back to the foundation for Orange County Public Schools. We also operate student-run high school branches in 6 OCPS schools, where students gain real-world banking experience and career readiness skills. Through our partnership, we're proud to serve our friends at OCPS and can't wait to count you in. Congratulations to all for your achievements tonight and for making a difference in the lives of your students. We thank you for all that you do.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Orange County Public Schools Board Chair, Teresa Jacobs.
Good evening. Yeah, I was looking for a response there. Good evening. Thank you. It is such an honor and a joy to be here today to represent the School Board of Orange County as we celebrate our Stellar Award finalists and honorees. When I think about OCPS educators, school leaders, and staff, the words that come to mind are compassionate, innovative, and intensely dedicated. Thank you for giving your time and energy to our precious students and for making each school and every classroom a welcoming place for all of our students. You are making a difference in our children's lives every day, but you're not just increasing their opportunity to have a better career. You are helping them become better citizens and, most importantly, better parents, and that means a better future. How many of you had a special teacher or a school employee who was that bright spot in your childhood? I'm sure you all did. I had several, but one that comes to mind was my sixth grade teacher. See, I didn't believe I was very good at reading, or math, or pretty much any subject. But she saw something in me that I didn't, and she took the time to point it out. And that simple gesture changed the way I thought of myself. And it paved the way for more confidence, a lot more effort, and eventually greater opportunities. You have been that person for your students. I urge you to be proud of that. Be very, very proud. Tonight is your night to shine. Before we go any further, I would like to take this opportunity to recognize the leadership of my fellow school board members. I'm honored to serve our district alongside these smart, committed, and very funny women. Please stand and remain standing when I call your name. Vice Chair Angie Gallo, District 1. Alicia Ferrant, District 3. Vicki Elaine Felder, District 5. Dr. Karen Castor-Dennell, District 6. And Melissa Bird, District 7. All right, to be fair, Member Bird brought three tables. Also, not with us tonight. Oh, you all can sit down. But for the record, they all followed directions. Almost nobody does that during that part. Thank you. Also, Maria Salamanca, representing District 2, and Pam Gould, representing District 4, unfortunately were not able to be here with us tonight. So if there are any other elected officials here, please stand so we can recognize you. And I don't mean that I'm going to recognize you, because I might not recognize you because you're so far away and that would be terribly embarrassing. But I don't think there are. So I would like to call attention to some other very special guests who are with us this evening, who commit their time, their talent, and their energy to OCPS and its 209,000 students. Would you please stand when I call your name? First, Ron Pollard, president of the Orange Education Support Professionals Association. Where's Ron? Ron, you're awesome. Clinton McCracken, president of the Orange County Classroom Teachers Association. And Clinton, great job. And Kelly Crumbaker, president of the Orange County Council of PTA and PTSA. Where is she? Thank you so much for all you do, for our students, for our parents, and for all of us. We applaud each of you for your dedication to OCPS and its teachers, and we thank you for your leadership. It's also my honor to introduce the superintendent's leadership team and thank them for working tirelessly every day. Would the superintendent's cabinet please stand to be recognized? Thank you. Now it's my time to introduce someone who needs no introduction in this audience. Yet I cannot mention her name without acknowledging how blessed we are to have her at the helm. She is such a gift to the district and our students. Her energy, her ideas, her leadership, and her heart are inspiring all of us. This incredible woman has been an educator for 34 years, including 32 years in leadership at OCPS. She knows firsthand the importance of relationships in schools because they were essential to her own success. Please join me in giving a round of applause and a welcome to our own OCPS Superintendent, Dr. Maria Vasquez.
Thank you, Chair Jacobs. I'm so proud to be here this evening celebrating the hard work and accomplishments of our stellar honorees. They help ensure that every student has a promising and successful future. I'd like to speak directly to the honorees. Like you, I've spent years working in schools. I know the difference one person can make in the life of a student. You represent the excellence and top-notch talent OCPS has in every part of our district. You know the value of building relationships with segments of your school community, and you can help bring out excellence in your peers. So here's what I want you to know. I appreciate you. What you do matters. My team and I, we see you. We see your sacrifices, your compassion, and the way you set an example for others. Our students and our staff love you and need you. Please continue to be the light in your schools, in our departments, and in our community. And even on the toughest days, remember that you are making our future better. Congratulations and thank you again. Enjoy your dinner.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, please direct your attention to the stage for a special performance by the Ohio High School Jazz Ensemble. Thank you.
Thank you.
stage, Nancy Alvarez and Jamie Holmes.
Hello again, everyone. They switched us. We want to make sure you're paying attention. We hope you enjoyed your dinner. Let's please all of us give another round of applause to the students from the Wakaiva High School Jazz Ensemble. Aren't they great? I hope you're all having dessert because they're amazing.
Oh, they're so good.
And save me one because I wanted to. All right, let's take a moment to thank everyone who is working behind the scenes right now to make tonight's event possible, including the staff at the Rosen Shingle Creek for their hard work in preparing and serving our dinner. Let's give them a round of applause. They can hear us. Our AV production company, AV Matters, Strawbridge Studios for the honoree portraits, and members of the OCPS event staff and volunteers. A big round of applause for them for making tonight happen.
All right, so earlier this evening we mentioned there would be door prizes. Everybody wins a door.
That's so funny.
I write my own jokes. When we call your name, please visit the table in the front right corner of the ballroom to get your prize and have your photo taken. So Al Scotti from one of our sponsors, Strawbridge Studios, please join me on stage now to draw the winning names. All right, so here we go. You ready, Al?
Never.
Never ready. All right, here we go. What a great prize to start with. Strawbridge Studios has donated two $500 gift certificates for photo services. That's right.
No.
A, no?
$500 Visa card.
$500 Visa card? Mm-hmm. It's a $500 Visa card.
Two?
Two?
Yeah, two gift cards.
I feel like I'm in an auction. This is great. Do I hear three? All right, listen up for your name to be called for the two $500 Visa cards, and then proceed over to the table. Let's see, where are they waving? Where are they? Over there, you see? Waving, that's where you're heading, over there.
Over here, in this corner.
All right, so here we go. The first winner is Camila Gamio Gonzalez from Keens Crossing Elementary, table 49. All right, the second winner is it's very suspenseful. Clarabel Rodriguez from Evans High, table 95. All right. Congratulations. And next, we have a family four-pack of Stellar Wonderworks tickets and a gift basket from AAA. Let's draw a winner. All right, here we go. Assistant Principal of the Year, John Miller from Meadowbrook Middle. All right, congratulations, everyone. A friendly reminder, you do have to be present to win. So when I call your name, please head over to the table there to claim your prize. And we have some exciting door prizes as well, some more, thanks to our partners in education. So here we go, from Icon Park. We have a gift basket, including wheel tickets and other Icon fun. And from Duncan, we have a gift basket to help with your coffee or donut fix. Blueberry donuts, those are my favorite, so we'll go together. And the winner is Sandra James Alvarez.
No relation.
No relation? Okay, you say so.
But I'd love to go to Duncan with her if she wants to invite me.
I like blueberry donuts. Okay, so congratulations on the next prize. This one's a lot of fun. From Galaxy sponsor Edition Financial, a cooler bag and a $50 Amazon gift card. And from Rogue Mobile, we have an Android tablet with a high gloss screen and protective case. And the winner is Jorge Quiñones from Acceleration East.
All right, still going here. Remember to head over to the table from Charity Recycling Services, which manages those big white recycling boxes outside many of our schools. We have water bottles decorated with student art and a $100 Amazon gift card. All right, here we go. The winner is Julie Vo from Palmetto Elementary, table 117. All right, so listen up, basketball fans. The Orlando Magic, they have donated a Magic swag package for one lucky winner, and that winner is Janet Salcido from Village Park Elementary. All right, this is pretty cool. Partner in Education After Media has donated 3 vacations. I know. I also go on vacations, I'm just saying. All right, you heard me right, 3 vacations. The winners will get a 4-day, 3-night getaway on Georgia's St. Simon's Island. So I know you all deserve a break after all your hard work and dedication to the students of OCPS. So the names of the 3 winners have been chosen by a lottery ahead of time. But you do have to be present to win. All right, here we go. You ready? The drum roll. All right. Winner 1, Paul Brown from Corner Lake Middle. I got worried there for a second when I saw somebody streak in the crowd. I wasn't sure. All right, we ready for the next one? Here we go. Winner number 2, Kimberly Fromington from Water Spring Middle. Where are you, Kimberly?
I hope she's here.
All right, here we go. Last chance, everyone. Our winner number 3 is Brenda Gherkin from Forsyth Woods Elementary. All right, congratulations to all of the prize winners, every one of you, but I think we all know everyone here is a winner for sure.
That's right. Congratulations, everyone. Before we move on with our program, let's take this time to thank our partners and sponsors for a variety of gifts provided to our finalists and winners. So much generosity here in this room. Herf Jones for providing each finalist with a commemorative pin and the Teacher of the Year with a commemorative ring. Jostens for providing custom stationery for our 4 winners and a commemorative ring to the Support Person of the Year, Principal of the Year, and Assistant Principal of the Year. In the weeks leading up to the Stellar Awards, the 21-22 Teacher of the Year and Support Person of the Year hosted the finalists in their categories during a dinner at a local restaurant. So thank you to Horace Mann, which sponsored the dinner for our Teacher of the Year. Equitable sponsored the dinner for our Support Person of the Year, along with a $125 gift card for each dinner. The Teacher of the Year and Support Person of the Year finalists and their hosts each received a gift bag, compliments of Horace Mann or Equitable. And our Teacher of the Year winner tonight will receive a VIP package from the Orlando Magic. And all 4 of our winners tonight will also be receiving family 4-packs to Madame Tussauds Orlando and Sea Life Orlando Aquarium, a gift bag including tickets to upcoming shows at the Dr. Phillips Center for the Performing Arts, and of course, gift cards as well from Barnes & Noble. So much stuff. Also, inside your program, you'll find a tear-out picture frame that you can use for a picture from tonight's event. It has a stand on the back so it can be displayed maybe in your office, on a desk. The frame is a gift to you from Galaxy sponsor Addition Financial. So let's give all of our partners and sponsors a round of applause tonight for their generosity. And now let's hear from our lunar sponsor, Cigna.
Hello, I'm Dean Mirabella, North Florida Market President for Cigna. It is my great honor and privilege this evening to support the Orange County Public Schools Stellar Awards, recognizing its outstanding teachers, administrators, and staff. At Cigna, our mission is to improve the health, well-being, and peace of mind of the people and communities we serve. Supporting education is essential to the well-being of all Orange County residents. We understand the key strength of any successful school is its people and their commitment to achieving the highest levels of success for our children. Our public school teachers and support staff are the cornerstones of our Central Florida communities, so we are proud to stand with you to ensure our teachers and staff get the recognition they deserve. Cigna's had the unique opportunity to provide the highest quality health services and well-being program for Orange County teachers, staff, and their families. Our promise is to help them achieve healthier and more secure lives, focusing on physical and emotional wellness. As your proud partner in health, we thank you for that opportunity. On behalf of all Cigna employees serving Orange County Public Schools, I'd like to extend my sincere thanks and congratulations to the Stellar Award nominees and winners.
And thank you, Cigna, for supporting the well-being of OCPS employees. So, are you ready to get the awards? Yeah! Well, after conducting a rigorous judging process modeled after the Florida Department of Education's criteria, our selection committee narrowed down the more than 450 nominees to 16 Stellar Awards finalists. But all of our honorees are shining stars and deserve to be recognized for their outstanding work.
I have some breaking news.
Oh, goodness.
I do. I really do. Yeah, we had a no-show for one of the prizes.
Was it your dress was half off? Oh! I'm going to get it later.
Stellar joke, Jamie. Actually had a no-show for one of the prizes, so we're going to be drawing another name soon. Oh. So, yeah. Action-packed night over here. As many of you know, we're going to get to that drawing in just a minute. As some of you may know, I am actually a very proud OCPS parent myself. Hillcrest Elementary, where are you? I love you, Hillcrest. There they are. And Howard Middle School. Where are you, Howard? I love you, Howard. So that's where my kids go. And I am passionate about our district and the quality education that my children receive. It's a tough time to be a parent, isn't it? It's a crazy world out there, and I put all of my hopes and trust in OCPS, and my children are thriving in this school district. And so, just as a parent, I thank each and every one of you for what you do every day. On behalf of all the parents, thank you. Thank you. To all of tonight's honorees, the people in their lives who give them love and support and make a difference every day. Here is the breaking news. This is happening right now. We're going to do this.
I'm ready.
I'm going to pull this one because you got to do all the other ones. And you made fun of my dress. So
I'm going to do it. Okay, what is this for? It's for the CRS, Charity Recycling Service, gift basket.
Okay. This is for the gift basket from CRS Recycling Service. And it's going to Pinar Elementary. Where are you? Lynn Laboon. Lynn Laboon, are you here? I hope so. That's exciting. All right. So our first recognition tonight is Assistant Principal of the Year, which honors an outstanding assistant principal who strives to provide excellent learning opportunities and strategies for students and compassionate leadership within their school and their community. At this time, I would like to ask our Assistant Principal of the Year honorees to stand. Your principal can now present you with your award. Feel free to snap a few pictures, and remember, post them with the hashtag OCPSStellar.
All right, so our finalists have gone above and beyond to assist and support their principals, their staff, their teachers, their parents, and their students, but you can see for yourself. Let's take a moment to learn and see exactly how exceptional they are.
he's just willing to look at the entire environment and see what's the most challenging situation we have, and he's openly willing and proactively going after it. And I think that's just something you can't teach. It's just something that's within him.
I think just to have a heart for people, at the core of who I am, service is what drives me.
And so if it's sharing his story because they need to hear that, if it is hearing their concerns and reassuring them, if it's making a safety plan for them, whatever it is that that child needs, he's gonna take the time out and do that.
My life experiences inform my role because I went through that not having a mother or father. I went through that being raised by non-traditional parents. I went through that growing up in a foster home. So I can relate and connect with the students just to articulate the challenges and experiences that they went through.
Mr. Miller is the go-to for everyone. They want Mr. Miller all the time, not just staff, but students, parents, everyone, but specifically the staff. They go to him not just for academic needs, but for their social-emotional needs. We call him Pastor Miller sometimes because he will give them that real heart conversation that they need to pick them up and move them on their way. And he just has a way of talking to people and connecting with people that just makes them feel really special.
I stay motivated by being a servant leader. I am always looking forward to being an inspiration to others, to students, to faculty members, to our classified members, because I'm gonna get in and I'm gonna work right along beside you.
In the few short months that he's been at Ridgewood Park, he has made just such a tremendous impact. And it was so instantaneous how well he fit in at Ridgewood Park, how much our kids loved him, how much our staff loves him.
What I try to do is show you that I'm willing to do whatever is necessary for you to be successful at doing what you need to do.
You can tell he loves what he does. One of the first things he said to me when I met him was, "This is a ministry for me. It's not just a job."
He absolutely is an institution. Literally, I feel like I could drop him off at a 7-Eleven in Daytona Beach and he would know somebody. And more importantly than that is every single one of these people that he knows, they would tell you about the difference that Mr. Campbell made in their life.
He doesn't realize that there are very few people like him. You know, like, he doesn't realize how special he is. The things that all of us see as these amazing things that he does, he just sees as, this is my purpose.
I think that she is one of those leaders that you feel safe with, and you feel like, I can go to her because she's gonna listen. And I think teachers need that. They need someone to listen, whether or not it's implemented or not. She's the person that you would go to.
I think that's so special about her is that there's so many people in our school. There's hundreds of people in our school, and it seems like she knows everybody's name.
I want everyone on campus to feel like they are a part of the big picture. Our school could not operate with every piece of the puzzle. So equity is a huge one for me. And I think that also translates into how I want to build culture in my school.
She's special to me because she cares about how you are as a whole student, not just in the classroom or at school, but actually how you are as a person.
Overall, my children, the children at Whispering Oaks, feel safe. They are learning. They are being taught by teachers who have a wonderful leader, which in turn inspires these teachers to be the best they can. And I think anyone that could be collaborating with Ms. Conley is lucky.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage our Assistant Principal of the Year finalists. John Miller. Marion Campbell. And Joyce Conley.
May we have the envelope, please? Okay. The 2022-23 Orange County Public Schools Assistant Principal of the Year is John Miller. Meadowbrook Middle.
Wow, thank you, thank you. Wow. This is truly amazing honor. Just overwhelmed with emotion right now. My mother was murdered when I was 2 months old. My father served a life sentence in prison until he died. As a child, I was a victim of emotional, physical, and sexual abuse and neglect. I've also spent some time in foster care. My life experiences closely relate to the students who struggle academically, socially, and emotionally. I attribute my successful life transition of who I am today to God's grace. My grandparents, my immediate family who's here with me today, and many educators who saw the potential in me. The work that we do as educators is tough, but it's not impossible. We create enriching and diverse pathways that lead our students to success. I'm truly honored and overjoyed for this recognition. I would like to thank Dr. Hardrick and the Meadowbrook Middle School family, Ms. Jackie Ramsey, and Orange County Public Schools for this distinguished honor. I also want to extend my love to my beautiful daughters, Jessica Robin and Jordan Rose. Lastly, I extend a heartfelt appreciation to my amazing wife, Dr. Edna Jones Miller. My wife is my accountability partner, encourager, and friend. Again, thank you for this amazing privilege to be named Assistant Principal of the Year. Thank you.
All right, are we ready for our next category? The second recognition this evening will be for our Principal of the Year Award. This award, yes, recognizes phenomenal principals who are committed to high standards and the success of their students and their staff. Principals play a critical role as the instructional leader at a school. They create and develop a team who will deliver effective, high-quality instruction and support each other. The entire atmosphere of a school is shaped by the way a principal leads. I'm the PTA president at our school, so you know what? I'm just going to keep it real and say the principal has to deal with us. And that's not easy either, right, Mrs. T? I know you're listening, yeah. At this time, I would like to ask all of our Principals of the Year honorees to stand. Your area superintendent can now present you with your award. Congratulations to all of you. Take your pictures and get your awards. Congratulations. And now, let's meet our Stellar Principal of the Year finalists. Take a look.
The way I try to keep my teachers motivated is simply with respect. I respect that they know their job. I give them the tools that they need. I give them the resources that they need. I give them the coaching that they need, and then I get out of their way and trust them to do their job and to do it at the highest level.
It comes very natural to her. She trusts the teachers. She has an open door policy with the students, with the parents, with the community, and I think that's key.
And then when she moved to Avalon, I moved with her there, and I'm not the only one. And I think that speaks volumes when, in this day and age, when you have teachers who say, that's someone who backs us up, that's someone who makes a positive school environment, that's someone I want to work for.
She always has a way of reminding us that in spite of any circumstances or anything that comes our way, we're there for the students. And she has a way of leading by example.
For me, it was a calling. Early on, I wanted to work with students to watch that spark in them, to help them grow, to help them learn. And I think that as my career has evolved through Orange County Public School, that I've realized that my most essential job and the calling that I have is to get the best teachers I can in front of our children.
You know, one of the things I always tell my teachers is our job is a calling, and we don't often get to see the finished product. So that moment when I see people who, you know, kids who I worked with come up and tell me how they're doing or trust me to have their own children at my school, that's probably the most rewarding.
So when I was younger and like around the third, fourth grade age, I was a very shy child. He got me engaged with more clubs around our school. Even now in life, I'm part of the debate team in my high school, and I would have never gotten that far or opened up as much as I have now if not for him.
I bring in people and I keep people who are passionate about working with kids. So it is important to hire the right people and then to support them. And to me, that's where I come in making sure that I can keep enough stuff off my staff, enough stuff off my teachers so they can focus on the core work of teaching their students, building community and family in their classrooms so that those students can succeed.
And so when you talk about someone who says that I'm gonna be there for you and then they actually do it, he just says, come here, let me make sure you're okay. I've been blessed with this placement. He's been a blessing to me and he doesn't even know it.
This is my 29th year of teaching, and I've had the really good fortune to have some outstanding principals in my career. And for me, Dr. Padawano kind of stands above the rest. And I think the reason for it, she is incredibly student-centered, first and foremost, everything that guides her decision-making at the school and in the community, it is always about what is in the best interest of the students.
We at Timber Creek High School started a program called Pit Crew, which is now spread throughout the state, where our students with special needs are really given so much additional support, and then our students who are part of the Pit Crew and helping out learn so much and gain so many new friends. So inclusion is just something that really matters a lot to me.
I would describe Dr. Padawana to them as someone who is going to meet the needs of their kid, who's going to care about them. She's going to know something about them. She's going to be approachable.
The most important thing to me is that every student finds success. And at Timber Creek, it's so important that every staff member, every teacher, everybody makes every decision each day based on what is best for students. That means that you might have to go a little bit out of your way, you might have to do something a little different, you might have to be a little bit creative, but we're gonna do what's best for kids.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage our Principal of the Year finalists, Karen Furno. Let's hear it for Robert Strength. And a round of applause for Kelly Paduano. Congratulations to our three Principal of the Year finalists. Let's hear it for them.
Can we have the envelope, please? The 2022-23 Orange County Public Schools Principal of the Year is Robert Strength.
I would like to say thank you to Dr. Vasquez and Dr. Armbruster, Chairperson Jacobs and Board Member Bird, and all of my fellow nominees. I had the honor to learn the art of being a principal under Maxine Risper, Bridget Williams, Carol Kent, and Wendy Ivory. They had vastly different styles, but all were devoted to making their schools special places. I've also had great area administrators who have helped me grow as a principal, including John Wright, Anna Diaz, Raheem Jones, Meredith Leftakis, Mindy Smith, Lakeisha Miller, and Ella Thompson. I also want to say a very special thank you to Patty LaPace, who took a chance on me 11 years ago and worked to find the right school for me. To be honest, I'm accepting this award on behalf of the people who really earned it, and that's my amazing Prairie Lake family. They are the ones who do the work each and every day to make Prairie Lake the special place that it is. They have taken the idea that we can serve everyone who comes through our doors, kids and adults, with a servant's heart, and be a family. They make it happen in their classrooms and in their offices, and they are the heart of our school family. I just kind of show up and ask what's going on. We don't always get along, we don't always agree, but we are always there for each other. And I am blessed to serve them. And even when they leave and go to other positions, they're always a part of the Panther family. And finally, I want to thank my wife, Leslie, a guidance counselor at Apopka Middle. There have been many nights when I have come home feeling like a failure. An instructional walk didn't go as well as I'd hoped, or scores weren't reflecting the hard work I knew my teachers were doing. And feeling defeated, I would often question if the way I was being a principal was working. And Leslie would tell me each time, be the principal you are. It will work. And like pretty much everything else, you were right. And I love you. Thank you all.
Congratulations, Robert. That is fantastic. All right, here we go. Our third award of the night, Support Person of the Year. This award, yeah. And they've got their own support team. It works out. This award honors educational support personnel for the contributions they make to their schools and district-level departments. They're truly the glue that keeps things together at OCPS schools and work sites. Attributes of a stellar support person include a can-do attitude, being flexible, multitasking, along with assisting staff, teachers, parents, and students throughout the day. It takes a very special person who is efficient, organized, responsible, and embraces change. I'd like to ask all of our Support Persons of the Year honorees to stand. Your supervisor can now present you with your award. All right, congratulations. And now, let's meet our Support Person of the Year finalists.
She started out when she was 18 years old as an interpreter, and it became a true passion for her, and a profession that she's really proud of. And she takes great pride in every single person that she interprets for.
What impressed me with all her interaction is that she understands deaf culture. There's not a whole lot of other who have not fully emerged into the culture that understand how we communicate and how we think. she understands both perspectives, and she's like, again, a bridge to both. And if there's any problem, she knows exactly what to say. She knows, she understands the different perspective, and she's right there ready to help.
My deaf friends and the deaf adults that I work with are hugely inspirational to me because they remind me every day why I'm here for my job. And I want them to have the best working opportunities that they can have, the equal access into meetings and everything happening in the schools, but then also to be working with a child. So to see a student light up and really understand a concept, that's where you get, you know, your heart just flutters a little bit when you go, wow, they got it, yes.
You know, Miss Sev, she just has a heart, and the heart is what leads her to be the exceptional person that she is. And she truly cares about all of the people that she works with. I just think she's outstanding.
When Ms. Sue engages with her students and with her parents, she really makes each one of them feel like an individual. And that is super special. You don't find that in many people, but she has this way of just making you or the kids or the parents just feel like they're the only person in the room. And that's really remarkable.
I work really hard with our Special Olympics program. I am one of the coaches at the school. So when we have our teams competing, practicing, getting together, we have a unified program. So it is our students with disabilities and students without disabilities that get together and they are included. It's a win-win for all students.
They have banners hanging at Freedom High School for what the Special Olympics teams have done. And there's a banner that they are a unified champion school, which is a national title. That now many high schools around the nation have. But if you walk on campus, you would see all that Sue has done through the students and their extracurricular sports, as well as the friendships they make on campus, because she makes them comfortable to be part of the Freedom High School community.
She really embodies what I expect of our school and our community. And her having this particular opportunity to be recognized just means the world to me as a principal. And I know it definitely does to her and the students and the teacher that she supports each day.
Working with families, getting the opportunity to really help them, you know, help them understand the importance of them being involved, supporting the schools, and advocating for their children, and really teaching them that they have these opportunities. And without their assistance and support, that their child, you know, may lack some of these essential tools. So for me, it's really working with our community and our families and the students. I love seeing their faces every day, and I love being able to be a part of that.
I think Jenny has created a bridge from the community to the school. I know that the teachers are working hard. I know that the students are working hard. But when Jenny comes in and allows herself to sit in the shoes of the parents and help them find ways to connect to the school, I think that's what she does best. And I think that's what is attributed to a lot of the successes at Sally Ride is parent involvement.
As someone that works and lives in that community, I'm very appreciative of someone like Miss Jenny Morgan, who hasn't given up on our families, haven't given up on our kids, and is always supportive of our teachers, of the principal and the staff. She is, it would be a great loss if ever she would get promoted somewhere, but she definitely deserves it. But we love her to death. We don't know Sally Ride without her.
Well, she's an exceptional person. She's not only a fantastic secretary with helping the staff manage what they need to do from the standpoint of what she is involved with payroll and so forth, but Like, she started our Green School Initiative. And we actually are a recipient of Green School Award. Just last week, we were at an awards ceremony for that, for sustainability and water conservation. She, with one of our teachers, started that. That's not typical of a school secretary.
I started Green School at our school because we didn't have that. So I worked with Latinos in Action and our PLTW and STEM classes, and we were able to create an outdoor learnscape. So we got funding for trees, and we have a recycle bin at school that we get money back to the school from, and we were able to purchase an arbor. And this year, we were actually able to, we received a School of Excellence Award for sustainability at Timber Springs from the Green School.
I think everybody is just drawn to Corey because she is just that type of person that she'll lend an ear, she'll lend a helping hand. She's always there if it's a personal crisis, if it's a professional one. She will help anybody and teach anybody anything. So I think the staff has felt really comfortable. Just, you know, you always need that one person to vent to, and Corey is that person for a lot of people.
The most rewarding thing is working with the students who tend to struggle more, whether it be language acquisition or just socially, and seeing the growth that they can provide for themselves and the joy that they have for themselves is more rewarding for me.
One of the many assignments that Mr. Rodriguez has is also working with intervention groups. There are a lot of our English language learners, and he is able to work with them and help increase their learning gains.
I mainly work with students that struggle with English language, and so I receive students from different countries around the world speaking different languages, and I have to gather them all together and really get them on track to what they're learning in the classrooms.
So he started as a para, and he is now in that para to teacher program through Rollins. He is here for all of the right reasons. He has created amazing relationship with students. For those kids that don't have that, just one adult to look forward to seeing every day, he is that person for them. I have seen him work so hard, and no matter what is needed of him, he volunteers, he wants to do it. Anything that's for the benefit of the kids, he is there.
I am super proud of the fact that he is always very positive, always eager to help others, students and staff. And the fact that he is studying to be a teacher, I just can't wait for him to finish so he can be one of our amazing teachers next.
So ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage our Support Person of the Year finalists, Amy Zev. Susan Scheuer. Jenny Morgan. Maureen Soares. And Alex Rodriguez. Congratulations. Let's hear it for our five Support Person of the Year finalists.
May we have the envelope, please?
Do you want to read it this time?
No. You're doing a great job.
All right. The 2022-23 Orange County Public School Support Person of the Year is Alex Rodriguez.
Okay, so thank you. I'm honored and humbled to accept this award. I would like to thank the school board and Dr. Vasquez for this honor. I would like to thank the district committee and the events team for their hard work in creating this beautiful night for us. I wouldn't be who I am today without the village that supports me. So I want to take the time to thank my village over there. I love you. And so I'm going to go and say thank you to every single one of them. Okay, so first I want to thank the amazing women that I had the honor to share this award and honor with. They have so many admirable skills and hard work for their school communities. It has been a pleasure to know them this year. To the principal who is always on point, if you can stand up real quick, just stand up real quick. Stand up. Lisa Suggs. Thank you so much for giving me incredible opportunities that push me to grow as an educator. I have learned so much from you and admire how you create a fun and open environment for staff, students, and parents at Vista Point. Mrs. Suggs always mentions that iron sharpens iron, and that statement is true, as everyone she works with is the best of the best. Thank you for showing me not only to be a boss, but to be an amazing leader. I would also like to thank Rollins College for opening doors for future educators like myself to pursue their degree in education. And realizing that support staff are essential to the success of our schools. The Pathways to Teaching program has provided me with an opportunity to reach my dreams that I will forever be grateful for. Shout out to Cohort 4. I would also like to thank the Possum staff, students, and parents at Vista Points for truly going above and beyond with their support and love, from the admin team, to the front office staff, to my news crew students, to the custodians and my other fellow staff members. Everyone at Vista Point truly shows what it means to have synergy, and I have nothing but gratitude for them all. And last but not least, I would like to thank my family and friends. The amount of support that I receive is a miracle. Everyone is always available and ready to help at a moment's notice. They really push me to be the very best that I can be. My parents are my number ones in everything. I tell them almost everything, and the best part is they actually listen. My parents guide me through life with endless wisdom. They are truly the best parents that I could ever ask for, and I love them with every inch of my heart. Thank you for all the support you've given me all these years, and thank you. I really appreciate this, and have a good night.
Ready for our last category? The moment we've been waiting for, Teacher of the Year. It's time. Here we go. As we know, teaching is not just a job. It's a calling. Educators strive to help every student unlock their potential and develop learning habits that will serve them well for a lifetime. The Teacher of the Year Award recognizes and honors the contributions of a talented teacher who wholeheartedly inspires a love of learning in their students. A teacher is the biggest cheerleader for our students in the classroom, and every teacher has seen that aha moment when a child understands a subject thanks to their help. To the stellar OCPS teachers, thank you for your endurance, flexibility, and going the distance by providing creative, impactful instruction to our students. You all inspire students to make a positive impact in the world. At this time, I would like to ask all of our Teacher of the Year honorees to stand. Your principal can now present you with your award. Congratulations. And congratulations, Ms. Pace from Hillcrest. Can you tell I'm proud of my school? Sorry, I can't help it, I'm biased. Congratulations to all of you. Everyone's taking their selfies. Don't forget, hashtag Stellar Awards. All right, let's get this going. Let's meet this year's Teacher of the Year finalists.
I had been teaching at least probably 12, 13 years when I met her. She was such a fresh approach to education, and everything was hands-on.
As educators, we need to be innovators. We need to innovate the way that we teach children so that they understand the world that they live in now. This is the world they're being educated for.
She really teaches them how to think outside the box, how to approach problems and to stay at it, to not give up, like the rigor that's involved with learning. And she instills in them that hard work that you need to succeed, and that if it's easy, it's not worth doing. So she instills in them to pick the hard road and go get it.
She teaches kids to think differently and outside the box, to apply what they're learning to the real world. That's innovation. It's not always about inventing something new, but innovating what we already have, making it better, making our world better. She does that.
In my class, I always start with empathy, and I teach them to see a need. And within my classroom, what I've taught them is that even at a very young age, they can be solutions for those problems. I want them to know that they can be that change in the world, and I want to inspire them to be that change.
She's remarkable for a lot of reasons, but what I will tell you in the first 2 years that I saw her when I first came to Endeavor, one as a third grade teacher and then as a fourth grade teacher, is, man, her class culture and class community is super impressive, and that she's able to just bring a collection of individuals in a classroom, young kids, and really turn them into a team, into a family.
Joy is, when it comes to working with students, when you talk about reaching them at their level, that's her forte. I don't know how she does it. She's magical. She just makes every child feel like they're special. You know, they're special, they're worthy, they're able, and they can do it.
I am motivated by my students every day. They surprise me. They ignite me. They encourage me to be the best that I can be, because I'm expecting the best from them every single day. So I have to give them my best.
She has an amazing class culture and sense of community in there. And those kids are, you know, they really embody like that family aspect. And I think that, you know, kids could really look back, and whether it was in third grade or in fourth grade, they could look back and talk about the experience that they had.
And I always send that message to them. As you move on from me, especially as some of these kids are getting older and moving on to middle school, look out for someone who needs a friend. Be that friend for them. A little bit of kindness goes a long way.
Thank you.
A media specialist is a teacher that teaches the passion for reading, to be lifelong readers, which means lifelong learners. And Miss Hastings really represents that passion and how it permeates through the Media Center for Lifelong Learning.
Last year, because of the excitement, I started our first book club at Tangelo Park, and the kids were so excited. They would come to the library every week. We would read our stories together, and then we participated in our first Battle of the Books Club.
She gets students passionate and excited to read, and to see that grow from my first year through now under her care has just been so incredible, to see the way that she inspires reading and a literature-rich community in Tangelo Park Elementary School.
The students were just so excited to be a part of that. The competition was really, really exciting, and they did really, really well.
I think that enthusiasm transfers and translates into the way that she cheers on our students now. So she might not tell you she was a cheerleader for the magic, but you might be able to figure it out from the magic that she brings to our media center.
As my students grow and move on, I really hope that they will always remember Mrs. Hastings, who shared that one story with them, to maybe open their eyes to others that may be different or may need a friend.
Oh, it is very simple. Okay, so my teacher is phenomenal. He's nice. He tries to make every day like a new fun adventure, and he tries to make it fun for everyone so everyone can feel satisfied and they can be focused. Fun and learning.
He has just such a contagious positivity, and he builds a relationship of trust with every single person that he comes into contact with, including the teachers, administration, office staff, cafeteria, it doesn't matter, custodians, it doesn't matter who it is. He empowers everyone to be the best version of themselves.
Being authentic is super important, just because we're all very different, not just physically, but like how we think and how we work on problems.
Like, his light shines on everybody. I get a little emotional thinking about it, just because he's so good at what he does, and he is the type of teacher that everybody wants to be a part of. I think that's the one thing about him that stands out the most, is he just is such a genuine educator.
As my students move forward, I hope that they remember that we should always have high expectations for ourselves, that we are allowed to be ourselves and have fun. I just want them to remember me for saying, hey, I had Mr. Cardoza. He encouraged us to be ourselves and have high expectations to help us reach that goal.
She's simply amazing. She's great. She creates greatness within the classroom. Melissa is actually one of those teachers that you will run across every once in a great while.
The most important thing is to make connections with your students. Without those connections, you're not going to get much out of them. You might get something, but the more you make a connection with a student, the more they'll work for you, the more they will want to work for you.
I would say the most inspiring thing about Melissa is the way that she interacts with her students. Watching her every day just interact from the moment that they walk into her classroom, greeting them with a smile on her face. She's always at the door right away to just greet every single child to make sure that they're coming in her room, know that they're welcomed. And it's just so inspiring to see, because we know not only do we want to focus on student academics, but just also making sure that students know they can come to a place where they're truly loved and comfortable to learn.
I am just blessed. Brian is blessed. It warms my heart that I don't have to worry about him throughout the day. And she's going to take care of him and all of the other babies like they are her own. So to Melissa, we appreciate you.
We appreciate you all. They are all amazing. And while we welcome Chair Jacobs and Dr. Vasquez to the stage, we are going to present to you our Teacher of the Year finalists. Let's hear it for Jessica Sardui. Congratulations, Jessica. Up next, Joy Cahow. Congratulations, Joy. Up next, Carrie Hastings. Congratulations, Carrie. Our next finalist, let's hear it for Francisco Cardoza. Love it. Congratulations, Francisco. And our last finalist, let's hear it for Melissa Williams. It's okay, you can cheer. Make some noise so we're not nervous up here. All right.
Can we have the envelope, please? The 2022-23 Orange County Public Schools Teacher of the Year is Francisco Cardoza.
All right. Thank you. Wow. To the selection committee, thank you. To Ms. Green and Ms. Del Pazzo, thank you for the excellent communication the past couple of months, truly. To Mrs. Welch, our current Teacher of the Year, thank you for sharing your wisdom with us all. To Dr. Vasquez, my principal, thank you for giving me the opportunity to be a part of the founding staff at Village Park, which is like family to me. Thank you for allowing me to be my authentic self and lead clubs at our castle that are life-changing for our dragons, helping them reach the highest potential. To every single magic maker at VPE, thank you for loving me and for your support. To my mentor, Ms. Aliandia, thank you for taking me under your wing last year and helping me adapt to a new state, a new grade, and new standards. To Mrs. Freiberger, Ms. Pancorbo, and Ms. Rivera, my coaches, thank you for listening to my crazy stories, questions, and always being there for me. Ms. LaRusso, Ms. Vollmer, and Ms. Williams, thank you so much for your collaboration with Amazing Shake, National Honor Society, Safety Patrol. Without your commitment, it would not be feasible. It truly takes a village. To OCPS, thank you for allowing me to be a part of one of the nation's biggest districts. To my lovely fiance, Travis, thank you for your constant support and endless love. To the fabulous finalists, thank you for your passion in this calling. Thank you for all your magic that you bring to your schools and loving your students endlessly. Finally, thank you to all the educators out there, which at Village Park we call magic makers. Thank you for being there and loving all of your students and cheering them on. Not every day will be picture perfect, but the love and passion most definitely can. Thank you.
We weren't going to pass up that moment. Are you kidding? Congratulations to all of the finalists tonight, all of the winners, and every single one of you who make an impact in the lives of our children. We appreciate you so much.
Thank you so much for everything you do. Please don't put the desserts in your pocket on the way out. I would do that.
That would be messy.
Congratulations, everyone.
It's been an honor to be your MCs tonight. Have a safe drive home. Thank you for having us. Good evening. Thanks for all you do, OCPS.
We'd like to ask our board members to please come up on stage so we can take pictures. I want to thank Jamie and Nancy for hosting this evening, and I hope you all have a wonderful evening.